Hello, welcome to the lecture session of Corrosion Control. Myself Kiran Kumar P, Assistant Professor, Department of Chemistry, ATME College of Engineering, Mysore. So today we shall discuss on the introduction to corrosion control, types of corrosion control, in that inorganic coating, anodized oxide method, cathodic protection, in that sacrificial anode and impressed current method, at last metallic coating, anodization of aluminium. So corrosion can be controlled by protecting a base metal metallic surface by preventing it into the formation of galvanic cell. If we prevent a particular metal to form a galvanic cell, we can prevent a corrosion. So there are various ways by which corrosion can be controlled. So in that, inorganic coating, metallic coating, and cathodic protection. So today we shall discuss about three different types of corrosion control. Inorganic coating. So inorganic coating is a process where a base material is a metal which has to be protected from corrosion. The base material is coated with inorganic oxide on an entire surface of a metal, where the inorganic oxide acts as a protective barrier. Hence, that protective barrier avoids further corrosion of a particular metal. Example for it is anodized oxide method. So it is a non-ferrous method. We cannot use iron as a base material because iron rapidly corrodes in presence of acidic medium. So we can use the metal such as aluminium, zinc, manganese, where the aluminium is made as anode. The base metal is made as anode, and inert metal such as graphite is made as cathode. So it is dipped inside an electrolytic bath containing sulfuric acid or a chromic acid and passing electric current from external source. So there will be formation of oxide layer on a base material. You can see the example here. Aluminium, which has to be protected from corrosion, it is connected to a battery, and an inert metal such as graphite is connected to a battery. The both metals are immersed inside an electrolytic bath containing chromic acid and sulfuric acid. On passing electric current, so aluminium will be oxidized. As a result, oxidized product of inorganic coating will be formed, such as Al2O3, aluminium oxide. So aluminium oxide will be formed on an entire surface of a metal, which acts as a protective barrier. Thus, further corrosion of aluminium is prevented. You can see an animated video here. So aluminium has wide range of applications. It can be having a different colors also, you can see here. So we can use aluminium for food storage purpose also, and automobile industries, and mainly it is used in structural designing. It's also used in the automobile and aeroplane industries. Why aluminium? Because it is weatherproof. It's also stable to the hot conditions and also in a water. It remains same. Hence, aluminium is an important metal. Let us see some examples of aluminium, anodized aluminium. Popular example is iPhone, which is made up of aluminium metal body, which is it is corrosion resistant. So food utensils, other utilities. So all are anodized, all are made from anodized oxide method. Let us move on to the second part, cathodic protection. So it is a technique where the metal is prevented from corrosion by coating, by converting the metal into cathode. Generally, the metal undergoes corrosion if it acts as anode. If we convert the base metal into cathode, it will be not corrode. So that is the idea behind cathodic protection. It's simple. It is a technique of protecting a metal from corrosion by converting it into cathode. So we convert our metal to cathode. So example for cathodic protection, you have two types of cathodic protections in your syllabus. You have sacrificial anodic method. So where a base material is connected to more active metal. You can see here if the base metal, so this is a iron pipe buried inside a soil. It is connected to more active metals such as magnesium. Now magnesium behaves as auxiliary anode. Why? Because it has less E naught value than iron. So it becomes anode. It undergoes corrosion. Whereas the parent structure, the base material, it acts as cathode. It is protected from corrosion. So since a metal is sacrificing itself to prevent another metal, this method is called as sacrificial anode method. So an anode is sacrificing itself to prevent the base material. Example, magnesium blocks are connected to sides of a ship. The magnesium blocks acts as anode. The ship is prevented from corrosion. You can see here, so this is a ship where magnesium blocks are connected, that acts as anode, and the ship is prevented from corrosion. So magnesium blocks corrodes itself to prevent the ship, entire ship. So this is a sacrificial anode method. All we have to do is we have to connect more active metal, or we have to connect less E naught value. Both are same. You can see an example here. Sacrificial anode method, it is a cathodic protection. So metals generally corrodes over time. So this method, sacrificial anode method, is applied to in refineries, storage tanks, bridges, pipelines, oil platforms, ships, etc. You can see here, this is a base material which is buried inside a soil. It is connected to more active metal, less E naught metal. So less E naught behaves as anode. This behaves as cathode. It is connected through external wire. So zinc undergoes oxidation. As a result, electrons are liberated from anode to cathode. So the metal anode undergoes corrosion. You can see the figure. Whereas the base material is prevented from corrosion. So this is a concept of sacrificial anode method. Now, the second type of cathodic protection is, we call it as impressed current method. So in this method, a base metal is made as cathode, is converted as cathode by connecting it into external DC source. An inert metal such as graphite is connected to the DC source. Now, this becomes cathode, this becomes anode. An external source of electric current is passed from a DC source, which in turn move towards cathodic area. So the electrons here is accepted by cathodic area to form a cathodic reaction. Since we are providing an excess of impressed amount of current, we call the method as impressed current method. So your cathodic metal does not undergo corrosion. it is prevented from corrosion. You can see here, it is connected to external DC source in order to prevent it from corrosion. You can see an animated video which clearly explains the impressed current method. So this is a cathodic structure which has to be protected. It is connected to an inert anodes. Inert anodes through a DC source. Now, an impressed amount of current is passed from a DC source. You can see here, as a result, corrosion of the base material is prevented from corrosion. This is about impressed current. Let us move on to the last topic, metallic coating. A metallic coating is a process of coating a base material with the help of another metal. So we generally coat a base material with another metal in order to prevent it from corrosion. It can be done by electroplating, flame spray, hot dipping method, etc. In your syllabus, you have galvanization, which is a hot dipping method. So galvanization is a process of coating base material with the help of zinc. So we coat a base material such as steel, copper, iron with the help of zinc in order to prevent it from corrosion. It is called the process of coating a base material with zinc is called as galvanization, and it contains a following step. Step one. The base material is dipped in, so this is a roller. A base material is dipped in organic solvent to remove any grease or dust particle. The reason for dipping in organic solvent is to remove grease or any dust particles present on it. Then it is dipped in the second step, it is dipped in dilute sulfuric acid. The reason is to remove rust, any rust formed on a surface of a metal. Then it is washed with water, followed by dried using a dryer. Here you have a dryer in it. The third step, it is dipped in flux, where flux is a solution containing zinc chloride and ammonium chloride. Zinc chloride and ammonium chloride. So flux is coated in order to have firm coating of zinc. It is dipped in molten zinc at 430 degree centigrade in order to have a zinc coating. At last it is rolled over roller. It is rolled over roller to have uniform coating of zinc in order to have firm coating of zinc. You can see an example here, animated video, which explains a hot dipping method of galvanization. It is dipped in caustic cleaning. Caustic cleaning is if any grease or dust particles present on a metallic surface, it is removed with the help of organic solvent. It is rinsing. Then it is dipped in sulfuric acid to remove any rust. Washed with water and dried. The next step, it is dipped in flux, where flux is a solution of zinc chloride and ammonium chloride to have firm coating of zinc. So this is a galvanizing process where it is dipped in molten zinc bath. So base material will have a zinc coating on its surface. So this is about galvanization of metallic coating. Let us see some examples of metallic coating, zinc galvanization. You can see nails, which is of galvanized nails, we call it as galvanized nails. You can see an handle of galvanized handle. This is a regular pipe and this is a galvanized pipe. You can see here a conventional paint coated metal. This is a galvanized metal which doesn't require any painting it in it. It is protected from corrosion. So this is about metallic coating. Let us have an overview of corrosion control now. We studied inorganic coating, cathodic protection, metallic coating. So inorganic coating is a process of coating an inorganic metal oxides which acts as a barrier between the metallic surface and the outer environment. Example for it, anodization of aluminium. So this is a typical example. Cathodic protection. Cathodic protection is a process of converting a base metal into cathode. We convert a base metal which basically acts as anode into cathode. Now it doesn't undergo corrosion. Example for it, impressed current method and sacrificial anode method. You can see here, this is a sacrificial anode method and this is a impressed current method. And metallic cold coating is a process of coating base material with the help of another metal. Example, galvanization. Galvanization is a process of coating base metal using zinc. So this is an example. You can see an example of for inorganic coating, an Apple iPhone. This is an example of impressed current method. And this is an example of sacrificial anode method. And this is about galvanization. Thank you.